gentlemen, please, if you'd like to take your positions, thank you. Line up, please, guys. We are ready to play some polo. Are we ever? So, Sam Moritz, how are we feeling? Did we have a good lunch? Clearly not so good. Well, I had a great lunch. Gentlemen, please take your positions, either side. And the umpires, we need a... Yeah, they're coming. Mr. Ollie Ellis up here on the Tower of Power, the third man, and we have Charles Seville and Marcelo Garahan, who will be the mounted umpires for this game. And once the players take their position, we will wait for the signal of the birthday boy. And all right then, so here come the Maserati. So just a couple of moments, ladies and gentlemen, once again, the formal invitation to request to ask you to come and join us here on the lake. And then we are ready to rock and roll and play some polo. Oh, I'm just being told, Tourist Board Mauritius, who of course have a little stand on the lake, they have a game you can play and Gewinnspiel where you can win four beautiful nights. Go and see your friends in Mauritius. So here we go. Gentlemen, are we ready? Retro, are we ready? Gentlemen, start your engines. Yeah, nicely driven, nearly centered. Well done. Thank you. Here we go, the ladies and gentlemen. Now, before we introduce you to the teams, can I have a traditional Sam Moritz warm welcome for both of these two teams? In the blue shirts, Maserati, and in the red shirts, Team Sam Moritz. And now it gives me great pleasure to welcome, as I say, a new member of the Sam Moritz Slow Polo family. Please welcome the captain for Team Maserati. A warm welcome for Mr. Kutla Yaprak. First Turkish player ever here in San Moritz. At number two, ladies and gentlemen, El Machina the Machine, Valentin Ovijo Estrada. At number three, ladies and gentlemen, he really is El Guapo. It is Adrian Laplacette. And jetzt ein ganz besonderen großen herzliches Willkommen für den Schweizer Fabio Meyer. And now over to the team in red, ladies and gentlemen. Team Sam Moritz, please welcome the captain, Valery Mitchenko. From Russia, at number two, ladies and gentlemen, the Frenchman, give it up for Monsieur Robert Strom. Now then, no stranger to this arena, the one and only Mad Max Charlton. And this young man, he's already won it four times. This is his seventh appearance. Give it up for Nacho Gonzalez. And of course, your two umpires from the Argentine, they call him the man from Del Monte, Marcelo Garahan, and of course, Charles Seville. Up here, the third man, Mr. Oliver Ellis. Thank you, Maseratis. You can now kindly exit stage left. Give him a little round of applause. Give him a wave. And now you can see why a Maserati is a babe magnet. There's lots of hot babes in those Maseratis. So, line up, guys. Remember, no biting, pulling hair, or swearing. You like that? You like that one? So, here we go. Ball's in play. Best of luck. And the first touch, he had it on the back of, on the top of his mallet there was Nacho Gonzalez. And keep an eye on this man, Max Charlton. A 10-goaler in the arena. As I say, also having won this on a few occasions. Great to see him back in St. Moritz. And there is the Frenchman. And it's so nice to see that we have the French and the English getting on for a change, playing on the same team. So there he is, Charlton. A genius, a master, a technician. Able to change direction at any given moment's notice. And that's the pass up to the front door to the Frenchman. Bonnet de Douche, he's put it wide. He's just put it wide. Well, it looks like Team St. Moritz, I'm not going to waste any time to give Maserati a run for their money. They got lucky that time. The ball went over the back line. So here we go. And of course, great to see a young Swiss player, Fabio Maier, in the saddle here for Team Maserati. Gonzalez, beg your pardon, Storm, looking for the number four. That is Gonzalez. He'll get it up in the far corner. He's got Max Charlton supporting him nicely. Still, Gonzalez sends it down the line towards goal, but I think he overcut it ever so slightly, just going over the back line. So again, Maserati's second attempt to try and get out of their own half. And as you can imagine, the first chucker is always a little bit of touchy-feely, get a feel for how the opposition feels today. And of course, this young man with the number three on his shirt for Maserati, Adrien Laplacette, at home on all the surfaces in the world, grass, beach, and of course, very much here on snow. Left it behind. There's a good talk there coming from the number three from St. Moritz, Charlton, talking to Gonzalez. Gonzalez will try and chase this. He's got a bit of traffic, a little backhander there coming from the number four from Maserati, Fabio Maier. Good pickup, and maybe for the first chance here for Maserati to get out of their own half. Well, it was short-lived because those little Red Devils from St. Moritz are making it very difficult for Maserati to basically get into second or third gear. Charlton, look at that pony go. Tried to pick it up on the near side. He got a little bit of luck there. And the Frenchman, Robert Storm, will take the man out of the action. Oh, what were you thinking? What were you thinking, Max Charlton? And we have a whistle, the first whistle of the game. Let's wait and see what the umpires made of that play. The first whistle so far, it's been a very fair game. Looks like we might have a penalty here. Well, we're just waiting for the info to come. Of course, we have a third man up here. It does. It looks like a penalty too. Or a hit from the spot. No, it's a penalty too. So a chance here for Team St. Moritz, who, as you can see, already come into this game with a goal and a half against them. Maserati slightly weaker on paper. It'll be taken by the number three, Max Charlton, teasing the crowd. The ball goes over the back line. So no mistake there for Charlton, getting St. Moritz up on the scoreboard, 1-1.5. A little over 3.5 minutes to play, and I think the umpires have decided if the players would like to, they could change ponies, but I think they're gonna play on. Ball's thrown back into play. Charlton, Gonzalez looking up, no one to play it to, sends it deep down the other side of the field where the number four, Fabio Maier, what's he got up his sleeve? A little back out. Oh, but he took a little bit too much time. Robert Storm kept the pressure on there for Team St. Moritz. And I think that whistle will now suggest that the players may go and change ponies. Give them a little round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. They're going to go and change horses, and we'll be back after DJ Mike does his thing. Now, remember, you can watch the action, of course, online on Facebook, Snow Polo St Moritz, as well as on Instagram, another channel where you can watch the action, Snow Polo St Moritz. And Retta was saying this morning we had over 320,000. Now it's 570,000. It's a rumor, so let's round it up. Let's call it a million. Here we go then, ball's back in play, the action continues, the second part of Chukka number one. And so far we've only seen one score, and that coming from Mr. Max Charlton. Maserati still trying to find second gear. St Moritz have done a very good job so far in keeping them at bay and not really allowing them to open up their game. I'm sure that will change. Well, they can't afford to make mistakes like that, especially if you've got a man like Max Charlton. He will try and take it under the next shot to goal, a good attempt. But he just puts it wide. So a repeat of what we saw in that first half. Maserati struggling to get out of the first, out of their own half. But of course the experience and the combination there of Charlton and Gonzalez is going to be a very tough order to beat for any team. And a chance maybe now here for the break. Ball had a little bit of a twist on it. Nicely picked up here. Maserati coming through. Well, there's the number two player, of course, Valentina Vizia Estrada, who became a world champion back in 2017 for Team Argentina in Australia. Also making his debut here in St. Moritz. But also he has a lot of experience playing on snow, so it's great to see him here at the home, the birthplace of snow polo. Well, that ball, as you can see, went over the sideboard, so there's going to be a throw-in. That's more like it, that's more like it. Hop, hop, Maserati. A little bit of a confusion there. It's going to be left for Laplacette and Charlton. Charlton, you've got your Brexit, but you're in Europe now, or part of Europe at least. The new word in England is not Brexit, it's Megxit, because now Meghan has gone, taking half of the Royals with her.
Maybe they come back now.
Possibly, yeah, possibly. So a hit from the spot, literally on the halfway line. It'll be taken by Fabio Maier. That's a nice little drill up to the front, looking for Kudla Yaprak. Kudla Yaprak hasn't been playing that long, and he's already got a few big titles to his name, also having won in Azerbaijan a few years ago. And now Nacho Gonzalez takes a nice swing, forgot to take the ball with him, but he's got Charlton. Charlton will have a little look, but he's got a wall of three defending players. Nice little near side backhand from Valentin, only as far as Gonzalez. A little flick of the wrist. Oh, and again, we were on that Belgian motorway. Nobody looking where the traffic was coming from. So just to remind you, of course, the right of way in polo is so important. That imaginary line, once a polo player hits the ball, ich sage das jetzt nochmal auf Deutsch, wenn ein Polospieler den Ball schlägt, dann nimmt natürlich dieser Ball eine Richtung bzw. eine Linie an und auch den Weiterverlauf dieser Linie ist das automatische Wegerecht, das, die Vorfahrt, die darf man einfach nicht kreuzen und Wenn natürlich das passiert, dann sind die Schiedsrichter natürlich verpflichtet, sofort zu pfeifen. Es geht auch um die Gefahr. Und bei uns Polo-Spielern, wir nehmen das Wohlergehen der Pferde sehr, sehr ernst. Es ist ein bisschen wie eine Ehefrau. Wenn man da mal ein schönes Pferd gefunden hat, das will man, muss man pflegen. Genauso wie eine Ehefrau. Nur, dass die Pferde nicht wieder reden. So, we have a whistle and we have a penalty. And it's in favor of Maserati. Yep, and Fabio has to go and get the ball. Fabio also a very young man, having played all over the world, and it's great to see him play here in the Engadine, the beautiful Engadine Valley. And it's going to be from the 60-yard line. So a penalty four in effect, defended. The defenders must allow a distance of at least 30 yards and they will mount themselves or position themselves on the 30-yard line. And the ball being teed up there, as you can see, by the number two for Maserati, Valentin Novigio Estrada. Playing into the sun. Nice calm walk up to the pony, takes a swing, it's definitely high. Just puts it out to the right-hand side where Gonzalez will either let it fall out of play or pick it up and try and run away with it. Gonzalez gets the support that he wanted from his number three, from Charlton. Gonzalez looking for a little gap, picked up by Kutlayaprak, tried to control it. Laplacette sends it back, looking for his team captain, but Charlton. Charlton plays it into the open space. Clever little play for him. Checks his pony. Has a little look up. Gonzalez going down the sideboards. There is the bell, and that ball will mean the end of the first chukka. The lovely people of St. Moritz, please put your hands together. Now, let me remind you, before the players come back, we have two big parties. I want to tell you where the official after party is first. DJ Mike, tell us what's happening tomorrow night and where.
Tomorrow night at the King's Social House, Badruch Palace, the official after polo after party with Mr. Mike. Tomorrow night, 11 o'clock.
Nice one. And then we have another party for you. It's the La Martina Snow Polo Party at the Vivai Hotel Stefani. Entry is 20 francs. The dress code is elegant chic. And that also kicks off at 11 p.m. So you've got plenty of parties to go to. And now DJ Mike. Now then, DJ Mike, I'm just going to just say to the lovely people of St. Moritz that we have the tourist board of Mauritius here who have a game you can try and win, and you can win four nights in the beautiful hotel Maradiva. And you know what? There's only one way to travel, and that is with NetJets. They are the worldwide leaders in private aviation. So why not book yourself a NetJets jet and fly to Mauritius if you win the four nights in the lovely hotel Maradiva. Good luck with that. Go to the stand here on the lake, and they will show you how that game can, how that lottery game takes place. You have a chance of winning. And best of luck with that. And as I say, there is only one way to travel with the world's leader in private aviation, our friends from NetJets. So let's do a little quick head count. One, two, three, four reds. One, two, three, four blues. A little bit like Chelsea versus Man United. 1.5 to 1. Chukka number two is about to start. Here we go. Ball's back in play. The first touch there from Fabio Maia. He's very quick off the mark. Charlton. The umpire, Marcelo Garahan, needs to make a little bit of space there for the Englishman as he turns on a sixpence. Kutlayaprak, oh, cheeky little Turkish number there from Kutlay. They call him Turkish Delight. Kutlay, you're good. Gift you good, Kutlay? Are you having fun? Well, then turn that frown upside down. It's called a smile. Here we go. Gonzalez. Nacho Gonzalez. Immediately gets a bit of traffic. Nice little near-side backhand from Valentina Vija Estrada, looking for Laplacette, and he's up against the Englishman. Do not mention the Falklands. Here we go then, on the far side. Again, nicely taken by Valentina. Deflection, it ball goes deep into his own half, but he's got the reds on him. There's the backhander. It just seems to go through all the legs of the ponies, and it ends up at Nacho Gonzalez's feet. Good lie. Needs to allow the right of way, of course. He knows that. A little bit of traffic there in the form of three Maseratis. Gonzalez, a bit of a deflection. He did well to correct that. Gonzalez, Nacho, here comes the shot. Or maybe not. He's just teasing you, ladies and gentlemen. He's teasing you. He does that. Again. Oh. Yep, there was that right of way infringement again. The man with the number three. For Sir Moritz Charlton, turning, and he ran into a little bit of traffic. Marcella Garahan and Charles Seville just explaining. You must keep an eye on where the traffic is coming from. So let's see what the outcome of that play is. Penalty two, I'm being told, by our third man up here, Oberschiedsrichter, Mr. Oliver Ellis. Ollie, of course, also having umpired here for many, many years. Part of the Sir Moritz snow polo family. Great to have you back, Ollie. So, penalty two, so that's 30 yards the distance. And whilst they tee up the ball, let me also just remind you, of course, we have La Martina in the house, ladies and gentlemen. La Martina, our official merchandise partner and sponsor. Go and see them on the stand, on the ice, pick up not only the shirts of all the four teams, but they have a lovely collection. Here we go then. It's going to be taken very quickly. And unfortunately, he's put it wide. Charlton not hitting the target. And it's still 1.5-1. We are in chukka number two with a little over 5 minutes left to play. Here we go then. Maserati on the far side. And it's nice how they involve and get Fabio Maia, the local lad here, to be very much part of the action. There's an near-side shot there on the backhand, I should say, looking to feed the ball up to this young man, Gonzalez. The ball coming there from the Frenchman, Robert Storm. Again, Gonzalez, he's got a bit of traffic. He's appealing. The whistle came as the number two player from Maserati there. Crossed the line. Valentina Vija Estrada thought he'd done no wrong, but he clearly came across that line, which had already been established by Gonzalez. And I'm just guessing this is going to probably be a hit from the center, a so-called penalty 5B. So a little over 4.5 minutes left to play. It's been a little bit thin on the ground as far as goal scoring is concerned, which again is a reflection of how evenly balanced these two teams, well, actually all four teams here this year are. Fabio Maia just teeing up the ball. And he's probably going to leave it to his number three, Adrian Laplacette. No, he's going to give it back to Fabio. Here we go, play is called. Fabio Maia. Nicely taken. Wants to send it back, comes off the pony of Laplacette, but Maia on a fast pony. Cleverly done, elegance in motion as Charlton puts an end to that. Very quickly, oh, they've done well, stolen it back. Valentina Vija Estrada, Charlton coming in with a nice open backhand. Now then the pressure is on in defense all of a sudden. The young Swiss lad, Fabio Maia, looking, and that's a great extension. Kutlay Aprak turns, but beaten to it there by Nacho Gonzalez. The Frenchman, Robert Storm, leaves it behind. Charlton appealing. Well, he got the benefit there. The umpire's allowing play to continue. Again, Maserati. Charlton wants to steal the ball back. He's done well. Charlton, here we go. Wait for it. Wait for it. So, quick pony change there. It's 2 to 1.5. And we've had a quick pony change. So things are starting to heat up there out on the ice. Here we go, ball's thrown into play. Charlton not messing about and not wasting any time. Here we go, Charlton. Max Charlton, elegance in motion. Will he save it? No, but you know what? You can still give him a round of applause. That was a nice little number there from Mad Max Charlton. And the Reds now very much coming alive. Maserati trailing now by half a goal. And there's the pass. He's going to end up at the feet of Robert Storm. Well, he did well to correct that. And a little bit of a triple. Yeah, I was going to say, normally people will fall off, but Robert Storm, he's bien joué. He's a good player. Yeah, strong French legs. A lot of Beaujolais. A lot of fromage. Fromage is the English way of saying fromage. Sorry? No, not frog's legs, French legs, love. French frog legs, yes, yes. There's so much meat on a French frog leg, you know. So, penalty 4 for Maserati. Now, who's going to take this? Charlton just having to go back behind the 30-yard line. And it looks like it's going to be Valentin Novillo Estrada. Knows he has to try a little bit harder. Oh, that's a nice drive, but he's put it wide. He's put it wide. Very, very good strike there. He did everything right. So Team St. Moritz have it once again. Clock, of course, does not stop. We're down to 2:45. We're in chukka number 2. And if you've just joined us, welcome. How do you do? Gonzalez looking to play it back up to Charlton, using the sideboards to his advantage. There's the pass. And now Fabio Maier, having a very, very busy afternoon here for Team Maserati. He's got Robert Storm, the Frenchman, trying to challenge him. Charlton will pick up the loose ball. Still Charlton, the two number threes, battling it out. Charlton will just hold fire. Still Charlton, he's got a bit of traffic there. Laplacette knows he can't cross that line, Charlton. As Gonzalez will turn on a sixpence. Now, he might run away with this one. Looks over his shoulder. In comes Laplacette. A little back is called. Picked up by Fabio. And now Kutla Yaprak. But he left it behind for his number 2. And then, as you know, is Valentin Novillo Estrada. Again, the Frenchman. Maybe this time taking the scenic route round the outside. Oh, this is good play from the Frenchman. Oh, he won't be happy with that. He won't be happy with that. Umpires having to calm down the heated temperaments now of some of these players. So Maserati again, deep in their own half. Everything running via that man, Fabio. Charlton, he just leaves him behind, stone cold. Fabio Maier, look at him go. Charlton hovering behind, waiting for the mistake. Ball still just in play. In comes a bump and a ride off there from, I think that was Nacho Gonzalez. So again, St. Moritz keeping the pressure on. Laplacette, he's got his hands full. He's surrounded by red shirts. Gonzalez making life very awkward for him. As you can see, they're going really fast now. Now then, this is what we came here for. Nice open fast polo. Kutla Yaprak gets a hook. There is the bell. 30 seconds left to play. Nice little open backhand into the run of Maier. Maier tried to pick it up. He got a hook there. Storm put an end to that. And now Laplacette needs to be careful. Gonzalez. He will make Butner flourish if he can out of this. It's turned. He looks to the umpire. He says, play on, not having any of it. We're down to the last second, ladies and gentlemen. That will be the end of the first half. St. Moritz leave the field at the end of the first two chuckers by half a goal, leading by 2 to 1.5. We'll be back with chucker number 3 and 4 in just a few moments. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big hand to the voice of polo, John Eric Frank. Thank you, Reto. Thank you. I love you all. I love you all. Now then, here we go, the second half. Now, I think it's time for you, the lovely people of St. Moritz, to get this game underway here. Let's start making a little bit of noise. I've heard a few people already shouting out Maserati, so let me hear the rest of you. Here is 14, Maserati. And who here would like to support the Red Devils team, St. Moritz? I think it's a very close call. Let's hear the Maserati fans again. Where are you? And let's hear the St. Moritz fans. Yeah, it's hard to call. We need a machine for that one. It's very even, very even, very even. Now then, half a goal in it. Half a goal in it. And we still have two chuckers to play. And I'd like to see that young man with the blue shirt and the number one, the first Turkish, German-Turkish player, Kutlay Yaprak, to show what he can. Yeah, come on, Kutlay. They want to see more of you. Yeah, we want to see ooch goals from you, my friend, ooch. All right? Just in case you don't want, that's three, all right? In your language, ooch is three. One, two, ooch. There you go. Some people have a ooch in the kitchen. We want to see ooch on the snow here. Where's he going? Come back, Kutlay, come back. So here we go, the Red Devils. Here we go, best of luck, guys. 6.5 minutes to play in chukka number three. Ball's in play. A call straight away from Gonzalez to Charlton. Charlton, he can run away with this one. He's got the Frenchman behind him. Charlton, Charlton, wait for it, wait for it. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that is what we in the trade called EIM, elegance in motion. Nice little goal there from Charlton. Third goal there from Mr. Mad Max Charlton. Just puts that over the sideboard, so things now are starting to heat up a little bit out there. Another throw in, ball's in play. Robert Storm will pick this one up on the near side. You know that they only play using their right hand. Gonzalez, he's going to have a go now. Nacho Gonzalez leaves it behind again for Charlton, and he's going to have to leave it for Robert Storm. Allez les bleus, Robert, oh, allez les rouges, I should say. Robert Storm. Couldn't find the gap. Maserati shutting it down nicely. Out on the left-hand side, there's the pass. I saw it coming for Fabio Maier. Hop, 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 Fabio. Nice little play. Maier to Kutlay. Ja, muss schon mitspielen, Kutlay. Backhander. Nicely done. Picked up by Valentin. Oh, that was a no-no. The line had been established. And the umpire, just looking to the third man, concurring with the decision made on the field. And it's going to be, I believe, well, it's going to be probably hit a throw-in. Hang on, we're just waiting. Yeah, I think it's going to be hit from the spot indeed. That was the call. So, play is called. Very quickly taken here. Team St. Moritz, and it's all coming via that man, Nacho Gonzalez. Charlton sends the Frenchman deep into the half of Maserati. Oh, they got lucky there. La Placette made sure. And now a chance here for the counter-attack. Here he comes, Valentin, Avija Estrada, Fabio wanting the pass. Charlton. Charlton will pick it up on the near side. Charlton, Gonzalez will take on two Maserati defenders. Oh, we overcut that slightly. As again, Valentin, uh-oh, uh-oh, uh-oh. Strom, nobody's got the ball. Nacho will get to it first. And we have a whistle. We have a whistle. 4:13 on the clock. And the umpires once again just comparing notes to make sure they give the right call here. 4:13 on the clock. Just conferring there, concurring with the third man, who agrees with the decision made by the two mounted umpires. Ladies and gentlemen, you know that there are a lot of hands, a lot of helpers who make an event like this happen, and I'd like you please to put your hands together for all the volunteers that help putting on the 36th edition of the Snow Polo World Cup St. Moritz, especially from the Liceo Alpino Swartz. Thank you very much, guys. Wouldn't be the same without you, that's for sure. So, Maserati now with a big chance here to claw one back. The Red Devils here, Team St. Moritz, have done a good job so far in keeping them at bay, not really allowing those two, especially Adrien Laplacette and Valentin de Vigier Estrada, to really open up their game. Now, let's see what Valentin can do here. It's 60 yards, it's about 55 European meters, and he's playing against the wind and the sun. Charlton tried to intercept that, but the danger isn't over. It's Laplacette. Laplacette will try and finish it. Oh, that was a bit cheeky and naughty. Gonzalez can't believe the umpire's decision. And I'm pretty sure the umpires will give the choice of a hit from the spot or a penalty too. Now, the hit from the spot in this case means just a couple of yards in front of goal. Now, are we going to see Kutlay Aprak take this? That would be nice. It'll be taken. That is Kutlay Aprak, I believe. And ladies and gentlemen, the first Turkish goal ever for Kutlay Aprak. Make some noise! Okay, Kutlay, that's one down, two to go to get your ooch. So he's got one, and they just trailed by half a goal. Yep, definitely a Hall of Famer. The ball's back in play. Laplacette up against Gonzalez. Strom. A little bit stop and start now, but it looks like it could be another advantage in favor of Maserati. Let's wait and see if that is the right prediction here. No, I think it's going to be hit from the spot. Well, they're not going to give this up lightly. And there is still plenty of time. 3.5 minutes. They're going to go and have a quick pony change. I'm going to hand you over back to Mr. DJ Mike. Right then, here we go. The remainder of this chukka yet to play. 3.5, or a little over 3.5 minutes to go. And that's a nice pass up to the front door. Good first touch from Valentin de Vigier Estrada. Has he put it through? Ooh, 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 how could that not have gone through? And now Charlton tries to run away with, all of a sudden this game is coming alive. Here we go, Charlton. up against the number four, Fabio Maier. He can't afford to miss it. Well played, the young Swiss lad, as he gives it back to the number two, Valentina Vizia Estrada. He will try and take it over the halfway line. He's done well. Oh, there's the pressure. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Lift at the feet of the Frenchman. Now then, Robert Storm. Robert Storm. He is completely tout seul. He's alone. Fabio Maier, again, he is doing so well back in defense. Another great pass up to the front door. He's fed it back to Valentina Vizia Estrada. Up against Gonzalez. A two-man horse race. Gonzalez can't get to the ball. Charlton spanks it back down the halfway line, looking for the Frenchman. And again, everything stops with Fabio. Oh, Fabio, that could be a costly mistake as Robert gets a bump and a ride off. Now remember, you can't tackle a player from both sides. Robert Strom, Robert Strom. Oh, unlucky, but a round of applause every day of the week. That was great play here from Team St. Moritz. 2:07, or a little over 2 minutes left to play. Chaka numéro trois, that's three in French, by the way. Or üç in Azeri and Turkish. Now, ladies and gentlemen, when they go and change ponies in 2 minutes, I need all of your support, all of your support. It's not a big task, it's something you can all do. So just stay where you are. After this chukka, I have a request for all of you. Here we go then, thank you very much, DJ Mike, rocking the snow polo. Here we go, a little over, or 2 minutes on the nose, left to play in chukka number three. And it's turned, turned around there, he's got to be careful. Can't obstruct, as it's going to be left for Gonzalez. Nacho Gonzalez, Gonzalez, give him an inch, he will take you for a mile, Gonzalez. And again, Maier, but I think this time Maier sailing a little bit too close to the wind there, crossing the line. That's what it looked like. We'll wait and see. Well, the umpire, I think, is saying it was a foul. Let's wait and see if that is concurred by the two mounted umpires. And if that is the case, we will have a penalty either from the spot or from the penalty two mark. And it's going to go in favor of the Reds, Team St. Moritz, to once again extend their lead. So 1:38 left on the clock. A little bit of a breeze, a bit of a wind coming in now. But still, beautiful, glorious sunshine here. Day one of the 36th edition of the Snow Polo World Cup 2020. What a great little goal there, ladies and gentlemen. So, they're going to line up in the center. Samoitz leading by 4 to 2.5. Ball's about to be thrown in. Marcelo just giving another few words of instruction as to how they need to line up. Charlton will send it back down the field, but waiting there is Adrian Laplacette. Gonzalez knows he's up against a very strong player, so the best thing he can do is turn, which is exactly what he's done. Laplacette gets the support there from Valentin. He's left it behind. Valentin will try and get past the Frenchman, Robert Storm. He's done well on the near side. Kutlay Aprak needs to make himself available. That pass will come. Gonzalez will turn, but so will Laplacette. Laplacette again. Gonzalez turns. Little lofted shot. And now Gonzalez will try and take the ball, fakes the backhand. There's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. There's the bell. Gonzalez, will he go for the cut shot? He does. But it's gone wide. And that is the end of chakra number three. Give him a round of applause. And now, ladies and gentlemen, what I need you all to do, please. And it's very, very easy. I need you all, please, to sing with me a very, very special song for the snow polo, the godfather of snow polo, Reto Gaudenzi's birthday. On the count of three, happy birthday. One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Reto. Happy birthday to you. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! Thank you very much, Dan Moritz!
Herr Schüsser, wait. Wait, nicht dieses bewegt, wartet. Ah. Merci, gell?
I didn't think about it.
Here we go then, chakra number four, ladies and gentlemen. Now remember, of course, like we always do, we will have a prize presentation after this game, but over on the podium again, playing, of course, for the Hattike Challenge. So kindly join us, if you will, after this fourth and final chakra of this second match of day one of the 36th edition of the Snow Polo World Cup 2020 here in St. Moritz, where we will have, as I say, the prize presentation playing for the Hattike Challenge. Yeah. And there's a young man, lieber Franz from the Crystal Hotel. Thank you very much. And of course, a big thank you to all our official partner hotels in St. Moritz, putting up the entire polo community here this weekend. Thank you very much indeed. So we are in the fourth and final chakra. St. Moritz still leading there comfortably by a goal and a half. So Maserati, you need to start revving your engines up a little bit, and you, the lovely fans for Maserati, need to support them, and that could be costly. Oh, Max Charlton, has it gone through? Did we hear a whistle? Is that a goal? Just waiting to see whether that has been approved. The two umpires, as you can see, in conference, making you the goal is given. The goal has been given. Let's have a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. St. Moritz get another goal, 5-2.5. Yes, the crowd go completely wild. So a little bit more work now for Maserati to do. Plenty of time, 5:13 on the clock. But they're gonna have to come up with something special in the remaining 5 minutes exactly on the clock. St. Moritz getting stronger and stronger throughout this game. A little bit of a melee there in the far left-hand corner. It's gonna come out for Laplacette, and I think he might have put it over his back line, but there's an appeal to the umpires. Another whistle will stop play at 4:48. Or has it gone over the back line, and we have the equivalent of what we call a corner I'm not quite sure, no. I think it's a regular foul, so a hit from the spot is, I think, what the umpires have decided and given. And Nacho Gonzalez will try and start taking the ball deep out of his own half. A nice, powerful drive there from Charlton. Ball goes over the sideboards. Voila. Well, last weekend, I've just been told, ladies and gentlemen, I wasn't here, unfortunately, but we had the third World Youth Olympics, the third time they were hosted here in St. Moritz. Sorry, twice the real Olympics, and now, for the first time, the Youth Olympics, so that was last weekend. So as you can see, so much goes on here in the lovely Engadine Valley and in St. Moritz. Come on. Holly? I'm not allowed to speak. He asked if taking phone numbers from lady fans is allowed or not. I said, I'm not allowed to speak. Yes, but only with the room number there. Well, I'm sure there'll be lots of that going on tomorrow night at the party with DJ Mike. So, a hit from the center has been awarded to Team St. Moritz, and it's that young man, four-time, he's won it already, Nacho Gonzalez, looking to find his teammate, Max Charlton. Good pass from him, Charlton. Will it be a two-hit play? He went for the long-distance shot, and only a couple of inches out to the right-hand side, so the scores remain the same, 5-2.5, 4:20 on the clock. Maya gets things underway. And he's found Laplacette, a little deflection coming off the pony of Charlton. Still Laplacette, but he's got Charlton breathing down his neck and not in a nice way. Oh, nicely played. Fabio Maia, the only Swiss boy out there, or the only player from Switzerland out on the field, as Robert Storm. He's got his hands full there with the Argentine, Valentina Vigia Estrada. Bien joué, Robert, as he takes it over the halfway line, or does he? Under the neck, it has a deflection. Four Maserati players again under pressure. Charlton, he will make mincemeat out of this. It's high in the sky. A little bit of wind will send it back. And another whistle from the umpires. Well, I'm hearing spot blue. I'm hearing spot red. Mr. Ellis, talk to me. It's a spot to blue, indeed. A hit for Maserati from the spot where that whistle came just a few seconds ago. And ladies and gentlemen, I think it's about time we gave this man a round of applause. He's been playing a blinder, the only Swiss lad out there. Give it up for Fabio Maia, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. So, from the spot, Fabio. Nice little shot. He was hoping that Valentin would pick it up, and he will on the near side. Good first touch from the Argentine. Gonzalez will send it back with a wallop of interest. Maia again, told to leave it. Laplacette. And another hook. Marcelo Garahan, the umpire, saw exactly what happened there. Well, the umpires again just confirming that they saw the same thing. And I think it's 3-2-1 on the clock. They're going to go and change ponies for a last time. I'm going to hand you back over to Mr. DJ Mike. Come on, St. Moritz, make some noise. Put your hands together. Yeah, you got to put your glass down to make the noise. Yep. Thank you. So here we go then, 3-2-1 on the clock. And Maserati with a big, big chance here to make it thrilling and exciting in the final phase of this fourth and final chaka. And it's going to be, well, who is it going to be? I thought it was going to be Fabio. Would be nice if Fabio is going to have a go. He is, ladies and gentlemen, Fabio Maier. Maier just puts it wide. Well, there wasn't much in it. A little bit of wind maybe getting underneath that ball, but it takes a lot of courage with so many people watching, of course, but he's been playing really, really well, and I'm sure he'll be happy with his performance, as will the team captain. So now then, back to the Reds. Gonzalez, and this time now, Maserati using the same strategy, shutting them down early, keeping the pressure on deep in the half of Team San Moritz. Gonzalez nicely sorted out that little problem there, but he's up against Valentina Vizia Estrada. Gonzalez wants to redeem himself and get that ball back, but it's Maserati. Getting a little bit messy now. Eventually the ball comes out to Robert Storm, as it's Valentin. Valentin takes a shot, will he take it? Oh, we tried a little under the next shot, and maybe Lapla, Opla! Is he okay? Valentin, Clinic Good, the fastest clinic on earth, ladies and gentlemen. Look at them go, give him a round of applause. But he's okay, he's okay. I can imagine. Oh, he's going to have a little look over. We'll be back in a few moments. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give him a little round of applause. Valentina Vizia Estrada. Right then, here we go. 2:19 left on the clock. And Maserati need three quick goals. Gut live, wir brauchen üç Tore jetzt. Du weißt, das Runde in das Viereckige, ne? So, 2:19 on the clock. Quick pony change, and I haven't mentioned them yet, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, these two teams, Team San Moritz and Maserati, will also have, like every team, a big, big array of boys and girls working behind the scenes. Can I please ask you, San Moritz, to give a round of applause for the grooms turning out these lovely ponies. Thank you very much indeed. Now then, 1, 2, 3 blues, 2 reds. Waiting for one or two more players. And then, of course, as I said, we will have the presentation of the Hattike Challenge right after on the podium. right behind the Tower of Power. You might just want to stop off on your way and pick up a nice little La Martina shirt, our official merchandise partner. DJ Mike, just tell us again what's happening tomorrow night and where.
At the Badridge Palace Hotel, King Social House from 11 o'clock. The official Snow Polo after party from 11. Free entry.
Wonderful. And we have another party for you, the La Martina Snow Polo Party as well. Tomorrow evening in the Vivai Hotel Stefani. Gates open at 11 o'clock. So plenty of choices for you to go and celebrate the weekend here of the 36th edition of the Snow Polo World Cup San Moritz. Here we go, 2:19 on the clock. They're all back out on the field. Now then, can they do it? Crazier things have been done, ladies and gentlemen, in this sport. So never write off a game until the final bell, the final whistle. Best of luck, guys. Just waiting for the ball to be thrown in, and of course waiting for the last player in red to come and join his team. There he comes, ladies and gentlemen, from Russia, Valery Mitchenko. Yeah, make some noise. Valery, the captain for Team San Moritz. Here we go then, best of luck, guys. Ball's about to be thrown in. Charlton will pick it up, does a little pirouette, elegantly done. Charlton. Still Charlton. Leaves it behind for the Frenchman. Robert Storm. He'll be looking to send it back if he can, but good marking up here from Maserati. And that got a little bit too much for the umpire, Marcelo Garahan. The umpire with the nickname Mr. 50 Shades of Grey. In his case, more like the 50 Shades of White. Well, it's been given to San Moritz, and I think it's a penalty four. The wind now slightly getting a bit stronger, which of course will make it that much more difficult. And the wind is coming from the right-hand side, from where the sun is. And as those of you who've been here before, you know how quickly once that sun goes down, it does get rather chilly. So now then, Nacho, I've got 100 francs on this with Reto. Or rather, maybe. Oh, that's a nice shot. And there was a good bit of defending there from Valentin Avizio Estrada. He'll pick this one up, plays it into the open space. Nicely done, Valentin. Behind him, Laplace said, but the Reds are not giving up easy. Oh, that's a great little play. A great little play. What a great goal, ladies and gentlemen. Make some noise for Nacho Gonzalez. So all of a sudden, it's 6-2.5, a minute and a half left to play. Charlton leaves it for the Frenchman. Again, Robert Storm, he's got Valerie to his left, but the pressure is coming on there again from, that's a nice little ride off there, and what a pass for the number three. Laplace said, can he get there before Gonzalez? He takes a long distance shot, watch it. Ooh, but you know what? You put your hands together for something like that, don't you? And it all started with the man from Switzerland, Fabio Maia. Well done, Fabio. Well played. For me, one of the strongest players out there this afternoon. Here we go then again, the Frenchman, Robert Storm, beating the man from Turkey. Look at him go. He's going to take him out if he can, Robert. Slams on the brakes there. He's got the number four player taking him out of the equation. Good ride off down the line, coming with the number three, Max Charlton. The umpires are saying, forget it, play on. Valentin, Novizio. He's got Kutlay at the front door. The Frenchman sends it back. It's gonna land at the feet of Max Charlton. He can't believe it, he can't believe it. Yep, he should have taken it on the near side. Max Charlton, not happy, but he should, and we all know that. Taking it on the near side, the line had been established by Maserati. Good call by the umpires, who I think are doing a fantastic job. We haven't actually mentioned them once. Let's have a big round of applause for our umpires, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Marcelo Garahan, Mr. Charles Seville and Mr. Ollie Ellis, thank you very much. So from the spot, Fabio Maia drills one up the front door. Look at him go. La Placette, the crowd are going to love you for this. Yes. And once again, it all started with Fabio Maia. Well done, Fabio. 3.5 to 6. And that is all she wrote, ladies and gentlemen. Please give him a big, big round of applause. Well done, guys. Let's have a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Well done, Team St. Moritz, with Valerie Minchenko, Romestro, Max Charlton, and Nacho Gonzalez. But what a strong opponent. Well done, Maserati. Well done on your debut. Kutla Jabrak, Fabio Maia, Adrian Laplace. Gentlemen, give us a ride by, please. Now remember, we're going to have the prize presentation. And then tomorrow the action continues. Day 2, throwing will be at 12 o'clock. Come and join us now over the podium for the prize presentation. And then, of course, enjoy the rest of your wonderful afternoon here. And don't forget, tomorrow the action starts at 12 midday. Thank you. Oh, here they're coming, they're coming. St. Moritz, once again, put your hands together. Kutla Jabrak, well done. Adriasito La Placette. And with the number 2, Valentina Vizio Estrada. And a big up here for Fabio Maia.